Welcome back out. We are at the UC Health Training Center, Dove Valley, for those of you that have been here for long enough. I still struggle to call it the UC Health Center, but I want to get them their plug that they deserve for being such a great Broncos sponsor. Nate Lundy, Sean Drotar with you, 5280 Sports Network. As we sit here on Monday, August 15th, practice is wrapped up. We know, Sean, that Saturday, Coach Kubiak was extremely critical of the offense. I think they looked a little bit better today, but not leaps and bounds ahead.
Definitely not leaps and bounds ahead. You're still seeing some of the same problems. You're seeing low passes, missed reads. And I think there's a frustration building with the offense a little bit. We saw Chris Harris and Emmanuel Sanders get tangled up. That's not exactly James Ferentz and Corey Nelson. Those are the kind of guys you don't want to see in a tussle on the ground.
I brought it up on the show this morning on Mile High Sports Radio that Sean and I are on 7 to 9 weekday mornings, that I think we may be to the point, I mean, I hate to say this, where I wonder when Coach Kubiak goes to Wade Phillips and the defensive coaches and says, could you back off just a little bit? I need to instill some confidence in these guys, because right now the defense is winning the battle every single day at camp. And the truth is, I expect this defense to be that good. But at some point, don't you need to get a little bit of confidence going, Sean?
Yeah, but what are you're recommending? What, that they tell the defenses, call off the dogs, everyone go half
speed? Maybe.
Put Von Miller at corner instead of linebacker.
Hey, they lined him up like he was going to kick a field goal earlier.
But
so
you're not wrong on some of it, though, because we watched these. Most of the dropbacks, all three quarterbacks, could have been sacked probably half or more of their dropbacks. Guys are laying off, as they should be, of course. But you're seeing that the defense just overwhelm the offense at this point. And it's an interesting idea, but I don't really know how you can tell a defense, because, by the way, this defense is going to have to carry this team every game, all season long. Yeah. I'm not sure you necessarily tell them, hey, guys, can you go half speed this time? Because we've all talked about it in all sorts of sports. You can't just flip it on and off like a light switch. And part of the reason the Broncos defense is so good is they are pedaled in the metal every single down.
Yeah, it is. And look, believe me, I understand that it's a weird balance we have to deal with right now, but I do want to see somehow some confidence, I don't even expect swagger out of this offense, because I'm not sure this offense has enough swagger.
They haven't earned it, for
sure.
They
certainly haven't earned it yet, but I do believe they've got to find some way to get some confidence going. That said, this defense looks phenomenal. They continue to play well. They continue to knock down passes. They're timing the routes. They're jumping them. We saw Will Parks with a great interception today along the sideline. This defense is performing extremely well. We know they have to carry this team based on where the offense is at. I'm just waiting for something to click in the offense, and it looks like I'm going to be waiting at least another day for that to happen. We know the 49ers come in for the game on Saturday. There's also going to be some joint practices out here. So throughout the week, Sean and I and the rest of the 5280 Sports Network team will keep you up to date on all of that. We'll talk to you mornings on Mile High Sports Radio, AM 1340, FM 1047, 7 to 9, each and every weekday morning with you. For Sean Drotar, I'm Nate Lundy. We'll talk to you soon.